Geordie, Newcastle 1, Chelsea 2. What do you make of today's performance?
Pretty boring, really.
Negative.
I think it was too negative. I think if we looked at the games we had success in last year against the big teams, so Man United at home, Arsenal at home, Chelsea again at home, we beat them by actually going at them, getting in their faces, pressing them, winning the ball back. Obviously, we didn't have Shelvey and Lascelles, which makes quite a difference to playing that way, but I think the success we had from doing it last year, we should have looked at that and played that same way again today. It was too negative. It was more like the Man City game last year where we just sat back.
You're accepting defeat on your point at best.
Exactly. We're just playing for a draw. The master plan almost worked and we got a point, but it was never set up to win that game. We were just trying to get the point. I think if we looked at every time their goalkeeper had the ball, even Rondon in the first half and then Hosu when he came on, they were dropping back to the halfway line and letting their defenders just bring it out. So when you've got players like Hazard, Pedro, Kovacic, they can hurt you if they're given time in the ball, and we gave them a bit too much. Although saying that, they didn't really create too much, and then the penalty, never a penalty in a million years. I've not seen it back in the replay, but I could see from where I was sitting, they clearly won the ball, so... disappointed, but I guess you're hoping you can get a result in these games. We didn't really set up to get the win though, so almost paid off in the end, but just not enough.
What do you make of obviously Jamal Lascelles, the captain, wasn't in today's lineup? Rumours that it was because of a bust up between him and Rafa, because he was arguing the case of three at the back. What do you make? That's not what the club need at the minute, is it?
It's not what we want to be hearing anyway, for sure. And especially, I don't think there's been anything confirmed. It's just a rumour going around on Twitter and stuff. But it'd be very surprising, because Lascelles has been the leader, and we know he had the kind of incident with Diame, was it, last year. So he is a powerful person in that dressing room. But it doesn't seem like him to kick off, because we're getting asked to play a different way. But who knows, we don't know what goes on behind the scenes, and I'd be very disappointed in him as our captain if he has kind of kicked off about playing in a different system. I don't agree the system was right, I don't think we should have played it, but at the same time, as captain you've got to go about it in the right way, and if there has been a bust up, I don't think that's the right way. And it's not great for us in the position we're in, where we've got a small squad as well. If we're having that going on, that's not what we want.
Nah, not at all. I mean, Man City next week, probably expect the same kind of tactics. Do you think that's the right way to go at their place?
Probably not. Because I'd like to see us press them a wee bit. If we look at what Wolves done to Man City yesterday, just take a wee leaf out of their book. Realistically, we're not going to get a result from that game. We can't go there and expect to get a win or even a draw. So I'd like us to see us press them a wee bit. Kind of look at what Wolves done. They sat back at times but also pressed them and kind of mixed up a bit. And City had a bit of difficulty with that. So hopefully we can go and give it a go. But really, it's just damage limitation. We need to get the points on the board. The next three games, been given a horrendous start in terms of the fixtures. We just need to get all the points we can at the moment. So losing the game, realistically, it's not the end of the world by any means. So hopefully we can put effort in. It's Man City, then Arsenal after that, and pick up a few points. If we could get 2 points out of that, I'd be delighted.